Hi friends, welcome to the new series JavaScript Hero to Superhero. In this series, I'm going to talk about some advanced concepts in JavaScript. If you are a beginner trying to learn JavaScript, there is another series, JavaScript 0 to Hero, in which I have explained all the basic concepts. In this video, I'm going to talk about hoisting in JavaScript. Hoisting is a JavaScript mechanism where variables and function declarations are moved to the top of their scope before code execution. In other words, we can explain it as, in JavaScript, variable can be used before it has been declared, or variable can be declared after it has been used. Usually, in most of the other programming languages, this will not work. Let me explain in detail using some code, so that you can easily understand. Let me create a variable var a equal to 10, and then let me console log this a. Okay, if I execute, we know it is going to print 10. What will happen if I just declare but I'm not initializing? This time we can see undefined. We have already seen this in basic concept series. Whenever we are not initializing, JavaScript assigns the value as undefined. Okay, now let me delete this declaration itself. What will happen? We are getting a reference error. A is not defined. Previously, when we failed to initialize, we got undefined. That is actually not error. But here we get A is not defined. What is the difference between undefined and not defined? This is going to be an important question and it is little confusing. Let me try to clear this confusion. In JavaScript, when we declare a variable, a memory will be assigned for that variable with value as undefined. When we initialize, that value will be replaced. That is why when we are not initializing, we get undefined. Now, why we are getting not defined when the value is not declared? When the value is not declared, there is no memory created. And so when we try to access the variable, it will search for that variable in the memory. And as it is not there, it could not find it. And so it will throw this variable is not defined. Hope you are clear about the difference between undefined and not defined. Okay, coming back to the hoisting concept. We know JavaScript always runs from top to bottom. Let me show that. Let me create three variables. And let me console log these variables. So we can see 1, 2, and 3. Now let me comment this second line. If I execute, we can see 1 is printed, but as B is not defined, it is throwing error. And as there is an error, the execution stops there. So C is not printed. If I uncomment this and comment the first line, we can see as the error happens in the first line, the execution stops there itself and none of the code is executed. Let me quickly uncomment this and comment the third line. And so we can see first two values and then the execution stops. So it is clear that JavaScript always executes from top to bottom. Okay, let me show you another code. Here it is going to print 3 undefined because we have just declared the variable, we have not yet initialized. Okay, now let me remove the second declaration and let me execute. Now we can see A is printed and then we get the error B is not defined and the execution stopped there. Now comes the interesting part. I am going to declare B after the console logs. Now we may think as the execution always happens from top to bottom, when it comes here, B is not yet defined. And so it will throw error, but it is not. We can see 3 undefined. That is because in JavaScript, the variable declarations are moved to the top of the scope before code execution. This is hoisting. That means even though we declared B in the bottom, before the execution starts, JavaScript actually moves the declaration to the top. That is why we are not getting B is not defined error. Hope you understood. Okay, now let me assign some values to A, B, and C. What will happen now? We get 10 undefined and 30. This is because in JavaScript, only the declarations will be hoisted. JavaScript initializations are not hoisted. That is why a memory is created for B, but with a value undefined. Only in line number 8, it gets the value 20. So if I copy this line and paste it after this line, we can see it is getting the value. So I hope you are clear that only declarations are hoisted, not the initializations. So far, I have shown hoisting using only the variables declared using the var keyword. Let me console log A and then let me declare that A using let keyword. We know if this is declared using var, it will be hoisted and will be assigned as undefined. But what will happen when we declare it as let? I had asked many people about the difference between var and let, and I have heard from some people that variables declared using var keyword will be hoisted, but variables declared using let keyword will not be hoisted. But actually it is wrong. Variables declared using let keyword will also be hoisted. But the difference from var is, the variables declared using var keyword will be assigned as undefined, but the variables declared using let keyword will not be assigned any value. And so we can see this reference error cannot access A before initialization. If we try const instead of let, we can see a syntax error. Const variable should be initialized. So let me say const A equal to 5. Now if I execute, we can see we get the same error as let. The let and const variables are not accessible before they are initialized with some values. And the phase between the starting of the execution of block in which the let or const variable is declared till the variable is being initialized is called temporal dead zone for the variable. And I also want to show this. Let me console log A. And then let me create a if block using true condition. And then inside that, let me console log A. And then I'm declaring var A equal to 5. And again, let me console log. And finally, let me console log outside the block. Now pause the video and think what will be the output. Okay, as we have used var, this variable A will be hoisted to the top. And so in line number 1, we will get undefined. And as the condition is true, it goes inside. And in line number 4 also, it is going to be print undefined. And in line number 5, A gets a value 5. So both console log in line number 6 and console log in 9 will print 5. So we can see undefined, undefined, 5 and 5. Okay, now let me change this condition to false. Now pause the video and think, because this is going to be an important one. You may think as the condition is false, these three lines will not be executed and so A is not declared. So this is going to throw A is not defined error at the first line itself. But actually it is not. When I say the definition of hoisting, I'm not sure whether you have noted this. Declarations are moved to the top of their scope before code execution. I repeat, before code execution. Actually, here I have hard-coded as false, but in many places, this condition is going to be dynamically evaluated during the execution time. But JavaScript has to create memory for all the variables during the declaration phase itself. So regardless of the condition, this variable is also going to be hoisted. So we get undefined and undefined, because these three lines of code will not execute. Let me switch this back to true, and let me change this var to let, and see what is going to happen. If I execute, we can see it is throwing A is not defined error at line number 1. That is because as let is having block scope, this variable will be hoisted to the top of the scope. So in this place, A is not defined yet. Let me comment this line. Now we can see cannot access A before initialization at line number 4. That is correct, because A will be hoisted, but it is not initialized yet. Let me comment this line also. Now we can see this code is printing 5. But at line number 9, we get an error A is not defined, because let is having only the block scope. So from this we understand variables are not always hoisted to the top. They are actually hoisted to the top of the scope. To add more clarity on this, let me create a function and inside that let me create a variable using var keyword. Now this variable is going to have function scope, not global scope. Now let me call this function and let me also put some console logs. If I execute now, we can see A is not defined error at line 1 itself. Because as this variable is having only function scope, this is only hoisted to the top of the function. And so A at this line is not defined yet. Let me comment that. Now it is throwing error at line number 9 for the same reason. A is hoisted only inside the function, and so it is throwing error at line number 9. If I comment this, we'll be seeing same error at line number 11 also. So let me comment that also. Now we can see undefined and 5. I think I don't want to explain why it is undefined and 5. So far we have seen how variable hoisting is working in JavaScript. Let's move to function hoisting. let me create a simple function which prints something. And let me call the function. So we can see it is printing. Now let me move the function call before we declare the function. In other languages like Python, this will not work. But because of Hoisting, this works in JavaScript. From this, we understand function declarations will also be hoisted to the top of the scope. Let me create a new function, but this time using function expression. Like this. Now if I call this function, we can see this is printing something. Now let me move this function call before this. If I execute, we can see some function is not a function. That is because this will be considered as a variable, and so only the declaration is hoisted. And as we are trying to execute the function, we are getting some function is not a function. Instead of executing this function, let me put a console log before and after this. Now if I execute, we can see before it is undefined and after it is having the actual function. That is why we are not able to execute the function before, but we are able to execute after. If we change this to let, we get the same result like variables. Cannot access some function before initialization. Not only for function expression, even for arrow function, it is going to behave like that. Let me show that. This is all about hoisting. Hope you understood and you like this video. Please subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.